In this tutorial, I showcase how to procedurally apply a fur edge to a piece of fabric. Houdini will reward you for knowing how UV and attributes can work together by allowing you to unwrap your own UVs in a procedural manner. This might help you as you iterate through multiple designs, without having to manually unwrap the UVs to preview the textures. We will start by draping a piece of clothes on a character. With the mocap pipette node, we import a basic character rig that we will use as collision. Inside the subcontext, we start with a basing ring shape using the planar patch node. One useful trick with this node in rig mode is to barely close the ring in order to preserve the hole in the middle, then use the fuse node to close the gap. We will use the UV quick shade node to give it some basic UVs on the points. We configure the clothes by tweaking the bend thickness and finally drape it onto my character. We also use the Vellum post-process node to refine the geometry and achieve the funnel shape of the fabric. After cleaning up the attributes and making sure I keep the UVs, we create the surface that will receive the fur texture. One way to do that is to restore the group given by the planar patch node that was damaged by the subdivide of the Vellum post-process. To achieve that, we intersect the group with the points situated on the edge. We extrude that group outward after promoting it to the edges. Now that we have a fur geometry, I will separate it from the fabric so we can work on it. Before we start unwrapping the UVs, we will make a quick fur texture. I grab the fur picture and use the Luma key to create an alpha channel. After cropping it, I flip it to create variation before moving it left and right to create a texture that loops. Any picture can be seen as a matrix of pixels. Each pixel has two coordinates that indicate the position of the pixel. By dividing the coordinate by the size of the picture, you actually get a value between 0 and 1. Those can be seen as UV's coordinate. By putting an attribute on my geometry, I can indicate to Houdini how my texture will be applied to the geometry. So points with an attribute UV of 0,0 will get the bottom left corner of the picture, and point of coordinate 1,0 will get the bottom right corner. So to apply this texture to our geometry, we need an attribute with two values. The first value goes around the fabric, and the second goes from 0 at the fabric to 1 going outward. For the sake of simplicity and highlighting the issues that come with it, we will start by showcasing the approach where we unwrap the UVs on the points. With the ends node, I extract the edges as polyline and keep only the one close to the fabric. Polypath allows us to merge everything back into one curve so we can get a curve view attribute that goes from 0 to 1 along the curve, either with the resample node or the UV texture node. After transferring the curve view back to our geo, we can create our UV attribute. The first coordinate will be the curve view multiplied by the number of times we want the texture to repeat. The second will simply be 0 for the point close to the fabric, and 1 for those away. Using the UV Quick Shade node pointing to the COP network, we are able to preview our texture in the viewport. Using a point attribute as UVs will trigger multiple issues. The first one appears when merging the geo back together and fusing it, to both optimize the point count and compute accurate normals. The points at the edge of the fabric are not able to have UVs for the fabric and the fur at the same time. We can solve this one by promoting the UVs directly to the vertices. In Houdini, each point as a vertex for each polygon it's using. The second issue being that the texture does not loop properly, as the looping point cannot have a coordinate of 0 and 1 at the same time. We could manually tweak the unique point that is at issue, or unwrap the UVs on the vertices, making sure the curveView attribute transfers to separate vertices when it loops. After getting the curveView attribute, we cut back our curve into many pieces, allowing us to scale them down so we can differentiate the looping vertices more easily. We do the same with our geo and inspect the closest point for each vertices to transfer the attribute. Because the unique points does not affect the vertex count, our order, we are able to copy the attribute back to our first geo. We now unwrap the UVs on the vertices, in our case every point has the same curveView, on both vertices except for the looping one, that has a curveView of both 0 and 1, solving the looping issue. We make sure to transfer the UVs from the fabric onto the vertices, so we don't have UVs on the points and vertices at the same time. If that happens, Houdini will automatically promote the UV attribute to the points. And now we are safe to merge our geo back together without any issues.